Hello everyone and welcome to my ON1 Resize AI 2023 review. So in this I'm going to show you how to use the software, what's so cool about it and what makes it different to the other image enlarging software out there. So the first thing I'm going to do is look at the photograph. So this photograph was originally shot on a Nikon D600 with an 85mm lens. I was actually on my way back from a commercial shoot and I had an 85mm lens still on the camera. I didn't have time to change it. It's like there's three suns shining down through the sky there at the moment. Beautiful rays of light, seagull flying through, massive amount of mist and storm clouds behind it, so it just looked amazing. Didn't have time to change lenses, so I fired off the shot. I had to crop it in along on it heavily then again to get this composition, which is what I wanted in the first place. So the image file size at the moment is 3872 pixels by 2585. It is suitable for printing on A4, kind of just about. Anything larger than that, you're in serious trouble. So that's why I want to resize it now today. There's a few different things you can do. You can bring it over along here and you can click on percentage and put it up to 200%, which is going to double the file size. You can put it to 400, 800%. That's one easy way of doing it. Or you can say, look, the long edge, I want to increase to 10,000 pixels. You can type it in here and it'll do it for you. Or you can go down along here to the width, you can go to the height, or you can type in the megapixels you want to increase it to. Or the other really, really cool thing is over here on the left side, you have different types of prints. So you've canvas print, you've matte print, Canon resin coated print, Epson canvas. There's all these different presets here, as well as PhotoLab, video, web and email. So if you say to yourself, look, what I want to do is I want to print this off in PhotoLab, let's say, right? So it's going to give you all these different possibilities. And you say, look, PhotoLab 40 by 60. So if I go along, if I click on that now, it's going to ask me for the crop. But because of the fact that the aspect ratio is correct, that's going to be okay. So I'm going to click on apply above here. And it's now going to increase that file size to 18,000 by 12,000 pixels. And it's going to do that automatically for you. You don't have to do anything else. So it automatically knows if you want to print that in a PhotoLab in a 40 by 60 print, that's the dimensions you need. Or if you say, look, oh, do you know what I also want is I want to bring that back and I want to print it by a 24 by 36, right? So again, it's going to ask you for the crop. The crop is okay. There's no problem there. So you can click on apply. It's going to increase the resolution to 10,800 by 7,200. How handy is that? There's no more maths. There's no more working it all out. It's all there for you. And again, as I say, you can go back. That's PhotoLab. I can go back to Canon Canvas if I want. And you can go for, we'll say we'll go down to the 24 by 36 and the gallery wrap. And if I click on that and click on apply, it's going to show me this is the image and that's the wrap then that's going around the outside of the canvas. How absolutely cool is that? And it's going to also enhance your resolution too as well. So it's going to bring it up to the 10,800 by 7,200. That is incredibly handy. But just for the sake of, if I just go back to PhotoLab here now again, and if I go to the 24 by 36 and click on apply above here. So all it's going to do here now is it is going to automatically increase our resolution to 10,800 by 7,200. I don't have to do anything else. It's done. Settings then is the next one. So if I go on settings, in settings, we can actually select the specific algorithm that is used to enlarge your photograph. It's on Resize AI 2023 standard. You have four options. So this is standard. You have faithful. So when I click on faithful, it's going to give you a slightly different algorithm is used. Then you have genuine fractals, so I'll give that a couple of seconds there now. So that's going to be a bit blurred, and then it's going to start pulling in along above and top here now. It should start happening there now fairly soon. There we go. So that's genuine fractals, and the last one then is bicubic. So the first two are the two that I find work best, generally speaking. So Resize AI Standard, if I click on that and give that a couple of seconds, that's going to pull in along here now. Now, the one thing you might see is a few fine artifacts around the outside edges. And in the smoothness control, I can adjust that so I can get rid of some of those very fine details or those AI glitches you're getting in your image. So I can adjust that up long and get rid of some of those very fine details there and then bring it back down along again. So that's in Resize AI Standard and also in Resize AI Faithful. So both of those algorithms have this option for smoothness. So if I bring that back up lying in there now, just helps to smoothen out your image. Now you are losing a tiny bit of detail, so it is a question of robbing Peter to pay Paul. Now the one thing you might want to do is you might want to go on to sharpening. So if I click on sharpening here now, I can adjust the amount of sharpening, but there's also there's fixed focus, there's screen, print, and there's more over here. So you can go amazing detail finder, fixed focus, high pass sharpener. And what you'll notice is when I go over each individual one, or if I So I know if I zoom in and find that birdie, there he goes. There is a bit of noise in the background. I still need to denoise this image, so apologies for that. If I go over here now again, and if I go to Amazing Detail Finder, you'll see how that's emphasizing the bird there more. There's fixed focus, high pass sharpen. So it's giving you a slight preview of all these different effects straight away. So if we go up to Amazing Detail Finder, I love that. And we say, oh my God, that's amazing. I absolutely love that. Boom. There you have it. Zoom back out along, print that off, and I can just click on done down below here now. And that is going to enlarge your image for you immediately. And the results are really, really good out of this. Like, look at that. Look at that. Now you might go back and you might say, look, that's a bit too much. I can just pull back the amount here too as well if I want. So you can just adjust this to wherever you think is absolutely perfect. Just the one important thing to remember is we're zoomed in at 100% here now too as well again. I can go to detail slider and pull up along the detail slider, and you can see how much detail that's bringing in here, but it's also bringing in a bit more on the background than the noise too as well and whatnot. Again, I'm going to pop this over into No Noise AI later on, and I'm just going to clean it out along. And if I go to threshold in and adjust the threshold up along, it's like masking, it's affecting how much of the image is actually going to be attacked or going to be sharpened, we'll say. But if I bring this up along, it doesn't look quite as noisy on the outside, but the outside edges or the extremities are still staying the same. Next, we have the protection sliders. So we have shadows, highlights, and skin. So what I can do is I can go out to shadows and pull this across. That's going to adjust the amount of sharpening that's applied to the shadow levels in the image itself. So you can help protect the shadows being overly sharpened or adjust them so you want them to be sharpened a lot, whichever way around you like it. So then we have the highlight slider. So again, that does exactly the same thing. That affects how much sharpening is actually applied to the highlight section of the photograph itself. We have the same thing with skin. We can adjust that too as well. So it affects the sharpening on the skin. So film grain then, we can actually introduce film grain into the photograph itself. Again, you have a whole lot of different options here, and it will actually show you a preview of all the different types of film grain we can superimpose on the photograph. And not only that, but let's say if we go for delta 400 and then I adjust the amount here now, you can actually adjust the amount and then the size here too as well. Tiling is a really cool feature to have in this, and let me explain to you why. Basically what it's going to do is it's going to cut your image into 9 different sections here now. Or if you want to do a triptych or a diptych, you can actually go in here and go 3x1. So I'm going to do a triptych here now and pop that over. And what it's going to do is it's going to split your image into 3 different sections here now. And you can see the tile size is 30.48x60.96 because our output is set to 36x24. So in other words, that's the image we want to create. So when I click on done here now, it's going to export this photograph into 3 different sections and save that in a specific folder. So if I go done, it's going to ask me there then, where do I want to put this photograph into? And I'll save it then, and then it's going to be saved as 3 different images. So I can get them printed and have this really cool triptych effect in one of my photographs, and I did it in a split second. Or let's say you want to create an absolutely monstrous mosaic. You can go into photo size, you can select here in inches, and you can put in 100 inches by, we'll say 68 inches now for argument's sake. Pop them in there, go down to tiling, and then say what I want to do is I want to have 40 columns and I'm going to have 40 rows. And what you can do then is you can print off all those photographs and stick them onto a wall, and it's going to give you an absolutely unbelievable effect. So the next one here then is gallery wrap. So if I click on gallery wrap and just open it out along, you can actually put a wrap in. So in other words, if you're printing a canvas, the outside edges you can actually set up here. So how thick the canvas is going to be, whether it's 1 inch, whether it's going to be 2 inch, or you can also change it to as well to pixels or centimeters. So you can actually see on screen where your wrap is going to be in the photograph itself. So as in the outside border or the outside edges of the canvas wrap. So again, that is another lovely little feature. But I suppose in all honesty, for me personally, what makes this software so blooming amazing is the fact that it just works so well. It's so easy to use. And then you have all these presets here for specific sizes. And just to give you an idea, so here, just to show you, because I didn't really show you the finished results. So this is the original image zoomed in at 100% down outside. This is the preview. And boom, that is how much of a difference that has made. So that's it. Thanks for watching, everyone, and see you out there.